If you've been paying any attention at all to things going on in Pinterest, you may have noticed two things. First, individuals with business accounts can now upload video pins. And secondly, very recently, Pinterest announced that it was changing the desired dimensions of regular pins to 1,000 by 1,500. What if you could marry those two? That is, what if you could produce a video pin that was 1,000 by 1,500, but do it using an existing square video? Well, I'm going to show you how using Adobe Premiere CC 2019. I've already imported a square video that I previously made and produced. I'm going to drag that to my timeline, and I'm going to select the video, and I'm actually going to move the playhead a little bit so that you can see what's going on here. The first thing that I want to do is I want to change the scale to accommodate the reduced horizontal dimensions. I'm going to do that by selecting Scale in the Effect Controls and changing it from 100 to 92.6. Press Enter, and you may notice that when I did that, the actual video shrunk a little bit and it now has a black border around it. That black border is no problem at all because I'm going to get rid of it in just a minute. The next thing that I want to do is I want to change the dimensions of the video to the 1000 by 1500. To do that, I'm going to select Sequence, Sequence Settings, and in the Sequence Settings, I'm going to change the frame size to 1,000 horizontal and 1,500 vertical. Press OK, press OK. Now when I do that, you might notice that the video is still there, but now it's got a black border at the top and a black border at the bottom. What I'd really like is for the actual video to be at the bottom of this pin. So I'm going to go back to my effect controls, and for the position, I'm going to change the Y position from 750 to 1000. That moves the video down to the bottom. Now at this point, I could add whatever text I wanted for my video pin and produce it and be done with it. But what if I didn't want a black background? Not a problem. I'm going to show you how I can change the background color very easily. First, I want to separate the video from the audio, and then I want to add a color mat. I do that by selecting File, New, Color Mat. Notice that the width is 1,000 and the height is 1,500. I select OK, and then a color picker comes up. I'm going to select, I think I'm just going to select white, select OK. The name for the new mat is color mat, that's fine, so I'm going to select OK. Now at this point nothing happened, but if I drag the color mat to my timeline below my video, notice now that the background is white. Before doing anything else, I want to extend that color picker all the way to the end of the video because I want the white to be there for the entire time. Now I'm ready to insert text. With the video selected, I'm going to select the type tool. I'm going to click somewhere in the white portion and I'm going to, actually the text that I want is Professor Minty. I want it bold. Probably I want it bigger than 62, so let me go ahead and drag this a little bit. And for the color, I want the fill to be green. So I'm going to select the area in the white, and I'm going to put the name of the recipe for this video, Restaurant Style Salsa. And let me center, justify, and let me move that to the center, and let me spell style correctly. Actually, let me make that just a little bit smaller. Yeah, that's probably good. And let me select the pointer and move it up a little bit. And center it again. Now this is the text that I just entered, so I'm going to move it to the beginning. And then I'm going to drag it all the way to the end because I want that to stay there for the entire time. Now I want to add the name of my website, pudgefactor.com. So again, I'm going to select the actual video. I'm going to select the text tool. I'm going to come up here in the white part someplace, and I'm going to put pudgefactor.com. I'm going to center. And I'm going to center again. And before I do anything else, I'm going to reduce the size of this because that's a little bit too big. So back over in my effect controls, let me go down and I'm going to move the slider. Let's see, that's probably good. I'm going to select the pointer and I'm going to move that down a little bit. And let me center it again. And there you have it. Before doing anything else, though, I want to move it to the beginning of my playhead, and I want to drag it to the entire length of the video. So let me go to the beginning and play just a little bit to show you what this looks like. So there you have it. Now all I need to do is to produce it and upload it to Pinterest for my video pin.